Saline S7 right here. This is actually chassis number one right here. But this one used to be owned by Roger, Paul Walker's partner, the one who died with him in that car crash. Then also, this was in a 50 Cent's Candy Shop music video.
What is up, YouTube, and welcome back to another video. Today we are out at the Petrol Lounge, and we're gonna be checking out their insane warehouse with 50 million plus worth of cars that are actually inside here. And we got Ford GT Mark IIs, we got LaFerraris, we have Ferrari Enzos, we have the Le Mans editions, Ford GTs, Saline S7 from Le Mans as well. We also have the first ever Saline S7 here that was owned actually by the friend of Paul Walker that passed away with him in that car crash in the CGT. So yeah, this is gonna be an insane video of a lot of really crazy and special cars, so be sure they all stay tuned to the end, like and subscribe, comment down below which one is your favorite car here, and let's get to it. Right now we're gonna basically do a walk around with some of these cars, the most special cars that are basically here. A lot of them have some really crazy stories to them. So yeah, we're basically gonna have him tell y'all a few of them from some of the crazy cars here, because we have the Saline S7R, then we also have a Ford GT race car right here. So yeah, we're basically gonna be walking around telling y'all a little bit of stories about these cars, and yeah, let's get to it. So what's your name?
I'm John.
John, nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
All right, so what are basically the most special cars that you have here? Because there is a lot of really like various cars here. A lot of them I'm pretty sure have some really good stories to them. So
yeah,
so what would you like to get started?
Depends on where you want to start. I mean, we can start with the big one right here, right up front.
Yeah, that's fine.
This one right here is it's a 1925 Hispano Suiza. So basically, this was what you would get if a Rolls Royce was too poor for you.
Okay.
Basically, this is all like, as in the name, made in a combination in Spain and Switzerland. The only thing we know about the original owner is that there's a family crest right here on the side, and one oil change receipt from 1939. After that, it was lost for 40 years. Oh, and at the end of the 40 years, it was found in a cave in France. Really? So we can only assume that they scuttled it away, hid it away from the Nazis during the war.
Oh,
because
wow.
Remember, during those times, Nazi officers would find these kind of cars in any of the villages that they pillaged, and as if they claim them as theirs.
Oh, okay.
And they were all, and good luck trying to find it back. So that's probably what happened. But yeah, since it was in a cave, the conditions were perfect to it, so I need a partial restore, but yeah, this is mostly all original right here.
Oh, okay, it's so really like, a sweet car. They're very big, honestly. I didn't expect them to be this big.
Yeah, I mean, this is what cars were back in the day, so you have like your trunk right there, where we kind of get the terminology for the trunk, your tool chest right here on the side for your tool repairs. You have to drive the car. Since there was no computers back then, these are the first kind of cars back then, you had to do all the timing yourself, so as the car warms up, when it starts up, you got to do air fuel, ratio, live timing, everything, and trim it all out on the steering wheel as the car warms up and adjust it as you drive on the road.
Oh wow, I didn't know that.
Yeah, so there's all these sorts of details with this car. So one of the first production cars actually had front powered brakes, so it stops really good going forward.
Oh, really?
Reverse, not so much.
Yeah, it's always good to have some good brakes.
Oh yeah, so but yeah, otherwise you have plenty of Fords. This Saline S7i right here is won Le Mans in 2010. Also won, I think it was at Silverstone, and I think one other race, if I remember correctly, during that same, a few other races during that year. But yeah, these two actually competed against each other that year. This was the first all-female team that competed at Le Mans.
The Ford GT, correct?
The Ford GT, yeah.
Okay.
The first all-female team that competed at Le Mans.
Nice.
Unfortunately, due to mechanical issues, wasn't able to finish. Okay. But that's Le Mans in general. Sometimes you survive, sometimes...
Sometimes you don't.
Sometimes you don't. Why not?
Yeah.
Then, other than that, yeah, we have plenty of things over here. Two LaFerraris, the blue with a blue carbon. Then we have the LaFerrari Aperta right here. as well. So you can notice the small details in it. Very, very beautiful cars, everything like that.
Okay.
But yeah, those are, you know, what's called, this one right here was made for, it's the one with the blue carbon, if you get a closer look at it. You can actually see it's blue comparison. This is actually gray carbon right here, so you can actually see the actual color difference.
Yeah, you can definitely tell right here from basically the lighting that hits it, you can see it really, really good. It's beautiful cars, but the contrast really sets them apart, right?
Yeah. Yeah, so from there, little Bugatti. 1935 for that Bugatti right there. So this is basically considered, this is a Pursing Bugatti Type 35B. Okay. The original ones, there's only like 40 were made. I think less than that, it still exists due to either being crashed and whatnot. Mm-hmm. But it's considered to be the most winningest car in all of motorsport history.
Wow.
So the thing is, there's only one guy, he's in Argentina, if I remember correctly, that knows how to repair and fixes the actual Type 35Bs.
Okay.
But the thing is, since he's basically got, he always wanted to own one day, but they're like 40 mil a pop.
Oh,
so,
wow.
So
these are very expensive.
So very expensive, but the thing is, like, he looks around his workshop, he makes all the parts for them. He's like, I can just build them myself and whatnot. So with Bugatti's blessing, he's made these right here. So these are definitely what's called basically one-to-one. Like even experts have a hard time telling the difference between them. The easiest way to spot it is the difference of how the transmission tunnel, the transmission itself was sandcasted. That's the only difference, but everything else is like one-to-one as it would be made back during the day. Because like even the tires, like all the treads right here, this is all hand cut out right here.
Really?
Like it's not like machined or anything like that. It's all done by hand.
So even
like
the tires are one-to-one basically.
Yeah, exactly. So this is a really good thing. Really nice piece right here. This one is, since it's more modern, it's one of those right here.
Mm-hmm.
It does have an electric starter. It does have an electric fuel pump. Otherwise, you have to be pumping the fuel as you're going along,
which
you did back in the day. You know, trying to go like, you know, 120, 140 mm-hmm. miles an hour, and you're pumping fuel to keep pressure in the tank and everything like that. That's a really nice piece right there.
Is this where you started off from, right here in the front, or what is this?
That's where you used to do, like, so like the whole crank in the car, so like the old school style. So like this one, the 1925, the MG sometimes, and we had a couple others here or there that either, this is how you used to start it, but thankfully as an electric starter, so we don't have to, you know, rip off our arm while doing that.
Wow. I honestly almost asked you what this car was. I didn't actually see the Bugatti emblem in the front.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah, so the Bugatti 35B, then we have, you know, typical DB5, Aston Martin DB5 right here.
Okay.
James Bond classic, you know, you can't go wrong with it at all.
Yeah.
Beautiful. Was restored to its current condition right here. But, it's such a pleasure to drive. So smooth.
Oh, I'm pretty sure.
The Saline S7 right here. This is actually chassis number one right here. This was their prototype and test bed for the twin turbo platform. It was crashed during development phases and everything like that, because, you know, testing and everything like that, got to make sure it's good. But this one used to be owned by Roger, Paul Walker's partner, the one who died with him in that car crash. Then also, this was in a 50 Cent's Candy Shop music video.
Oh, okay.
So you'll see, if you watch the music video closely, you see that this is the car that he was leaning against right here in the music video.
Never knew that. That's really sweet.
So it does have a little bit of history in various degrees and everything like that. Acura NSX right here. This is a Zanardi edition number 2. So basically, Alex Zanardi, after Arne Senna passed away, Alex Zanardi came in, helped continue developing the NSX.
Mm-hmm.
And with that, they had the Zanardi edition.
Okay.
Number 0, Honda kept. Number 1 went to Alex Zanardi himself. And number 2, which is this one right here, is the first publicly sold one.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
First publicly sold NSX?
First publicly sold Zanardi edition.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
That's very nice.
Yeah, but yeah, all sorts of stories up and down. I mean, you have your GT2 RSs, aplenty, and Porsche Landia right here, many GT3s, GT4s, generations. Pistas galore, turbos. See what else. Depends on what it is you want to talk about. We even have a big kahuna right here, the locomotive's rally fighter.
Yeah. I've seen that y'all have a YouTube video dedicated to this car right here, right?
Oh, yeah, that we do. That was Jack that did that YouTube video right there. He's one of the owners of the company here. No.
So as y'all can see, there is really a bunch of cars here, really special cars. I think the value that they basically said that this warehouse was probably worth is in between $50 million to $100 million. It's really crazy. We got this Terminator Mustang with that really rare paint color that you, if you ever chip it basically, and you want to get it resprayed, you basically have to get the whole car resprayed. If not, the paint's not basically going to set on there correctly and it's not going to have the cool effects that it usually has. And then over here we have a Lamborghini Gallardo. We also have a Lamborghini Aventador S or LP700. Let me see if I can go check it out. Every time I basically walk through the rows, you gotta take off your bag, but I mean, I kinda get it because you don't want any of these cars scratched up. But check out the color on this Aventador. This is a dream car right here and it looks absolutely phenomenal. Just check this out. All right, actually, this is a Lamborghini Aventador Ultima. The only way I could really tell is because it has the two exits from the exhaust out right in the middle in the back, just like an SVJ. This is the last model right here. I don't know if it's the last car, obviously, but this is the last Aventador that was ever produced with a naturally aspirated V12. Beautiful, beautiful color that they chose for this car. And hopefully one day we can actually end up basically owning one of these cars, straight piping it and having a whole lot of fun with it. And right here we have a Huracan in this beautiful, really dark blue color. And then check out the forged carbon wing that it has out in the back. Looks so beautiful. Absolutely love Lamborghini Huracans. And then right here we have a blue and green Huracan STO. This car looks phenomenal. Check this out. The color variants that it has, green and blue. I honestly love the way that it looks. Hopefully one day we can own an STO that looks somewhat like this. But if this isn't your choice of cars, basically, or colors in an STO, we have a black and yellow Batmobile. This thing looks phenomenal right here. Just check that out. Black and yellow, you cannot go wrong with that. Just like the song says, black and yellow, black and yellow. Because we have a Radical right here. I've never seen this Radical. I think I saw a red one out in Houston one time, and then I saw another red one that was here in Austin, but it was like kind of one of these, not the ones that have like the whole top over it. Yeah, imagine racing on a track with this car right here. Super insane. I absolutely love the style that these have. They're so aggressive. Giant carbon fiber wing that it has. Pretty sure they sound ridiculous as well. They can't just be fast for nothing. And then we have some cars under covers. I'm pretty sure if y'all know cars, y'all know which ones they are. But right here we have a McLaren 600LT. This car looks absolutely beautiful. I love that they basically implemented the double exit exhaust out the top of the top bonnet out in the back. It looks so beautiful. Right here we have a Ferrari Scuderia. Then we have a 458. This thing looks beautiful. Blue with blue on blue, a dark blue and then yellow. Really light blue, what's it called, colors that it has as the stripes in the bottom. They look beautiful right here. And then I believe this is either a Ferrari 599 or Ferrari California. Let's see if we can find that out because I think you can distinguish them by the exhaust tips. If they have like double exhaust tips stacked up top, that's where you basically notice if it is a California, I think. But I do believe this is a 599. It looks so good in this. Modified, 45, fitting like a motor car. I ain't regular, feel like Jordan wearing 45. Traumatized, victimized, seen some of my n***s die. Knock you off a base with a bat when them n***s slide. Homicide, genocide, televised, emphasize, perpetuating war. Tell that n***a he gon' pick a side. Hood ties from hood lines, my n***a doing dope lines. I'm running to the cops, that's a big exercise. Don't run into the cops, that's the motto. I don't see it coming to an end like Legato. Get chipped like Staccato, send a wave through the hood, now I'm sounding like Verado. Why you eat bread with avocado? We be trying to die shells before it landing our tomato.
Singing all my sorrows on Apollo. I've been trying to pave the way, but they didn't tell me it was potos. America ain't dreaming, they been skimming when the birth of a nation came from black. We all know it's black.
And something that I also didn't notice was that on the Fordgt road editions, this one right here is like a race livery that they basically put on it. But look at the way that the wings stick up. I've never seen a Fordgt wing lifted up like that. That's basically for like air braking, I'm guessing. But it looks absolutely insane for them to just have it straight up in the air here just for show. It looks absolutely insane.
I am not the answer, no, I can never trick, let the bitch use my bitch with a kiss on my lips like, I am not a pimp with a limp, I'm a man with a gift and I'm doing my shit like, tell them other nips, I'm the nip, I'm the man in the city and my bank account bigger and my body count bigger.
Alright you guys, so we basically walked around this whole building. It's an absolutely insane amount of cars that they have here. They have a Saline S7, they have the CGT, Le Mans winning 4 GTs. They have so many damn cars here that are absolutely insane. Hopefully y'all liked all the content that I was basically able to capture here. And I'll see you on the next video.